Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Sameen here with Sira Masters, developing the Muslim mindset for success. And I just had a quick thought I wanted to share with you about mindset. A very simple point, a very simple point that I just thought of, which is actually very rare to come across. And that is, I was washing my hands, okay? I'm washing my hands, and it's a type of tap that you press it and a bit of water comes out and then it stops and you have to press it again, okay? Now, that was annoying me because I didn't want to just wash my hands. I actually wanted to have a thought. But it annoyed me. But then I quickly realized that, obviously, if you have this mechanism where you have to press each time to get a bit of water, then it's going to save water. And for what 99% of people are doing, which is just washing their hands at that place, that is actually a very good thing for saving water, not wasting water. That's what is needed, Annie. And so the very rare thing, which should be very common among people, especially Muslims with the right mindset, is to not just like and dislike things or be annoyed or not be annoyed with things based on your personal benefit. So in this case, it was a disadvantage for me. It was an annoyance for me that I had to keep pressing it to get the water to come out. But on the bigger scale, overall, and for the benefit of the whole world or the whole city or the whole community or whatever, it's obviously a better thing that it was, the mechanism works that way, because we're going to waste less water. This is not a place that was designed, Yanni, for wudu. This is not what 99% of people are going to be using it for. So therefore, it's actually a good thing, but it just happened that it went against what my benefit was. So why should I dislike it? I should actually like it, because overall it's good. Just for me specifically in that specific circumstance, it was a bit annoying. And I just find this is very common, that people simply dislike and like things based on their specific benefit. Whereas even if they are 1% of the population that they're talking about, and they recognize they're just 1% and everyone else is different to them and they have different benefits and different things they want out of the place, whatever, they still just support things that are in their benefit and don't support things that are not in their benefit. For example, something like fees, like university fees. Everyone is against university fees being high or being higher or going higher. In whatever country, everyone would be against that. However, they never sit to think about where, if we don't pay, or if we don't pay that much, or if we don't pay more, where will the money come from? Where will the money come from? And that is more of a global way of thinking, that the money just doesn't come out of nowhere to have a university and to have teachers and to pay staff and to build buildings. It doesn't come out of nowhere. It has to come out of somewhere. Likewise, people want certain benefits. Let's say when someone is in university, they get grants from the government. Okay, so putting university fees aside, grants. Let's say the government takes away grants for these people. Certain people whose parents earn less than a certain amount, usually they get $500 a week, let's say. That's quite a lot of money. $500 a week. And then the government decides that they're going to get rid of these grants. The people that are receiving the grants would be annoyed. They feel entitled that I should be getting these grants. However, did you sit down and think, okay, putting my personal benefit aside, what is the best for the overall community and the overall city or country that I live in? Or did you just think what your benefit is? So I just think this is such a basic thing, and it just seems quite rare as well. The way of a Muslim, the Muslim mindset is to think globally and think overall and not just think very almost just follow your emotions and your desires of what benefits you and what doesn't benefit you. We should be people ulul albab, the people of deep thought, people that think a bit deeper than just your surface level of desires and benefits for yourself. So this has been Amin with Sira Masters. Hope this benefited you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.